Hello friends, welcome to Freshers Live. Today is 1st Feb. Here, I will discuss all the important questions that may be asked from today's current affairs and important facts related with each question. But before moving forward, let's check the answer for the question asked in last video. The correct answer is option B, Denmark. So, dear friends, watch the video very carefully and try to answer the questions asked at the end of the video. You can download the PDF of the video from the link provided in the description. You can also download the PDF from our website as well as WhatsApp groups. Also, you can find the link for the Hindi version of this video in the below given description box. So, let's start. Here, the most awaited February 1 has arrived. And so does the interim budget announcement by the Finance Minister Piyush Goyal. If you are an aspirant, pen down all the important updates about the interim budget 2019. You can find it in our Freshers Live website. Let's go to the first question. How much did the government announce for the Defence Ministry in the interim budget 2019? The Finance Minister Piyush Goyal presented the interim budget for 2019-20. The amount allocated for the defense is rupees 3 lakh crore. Yes, the answer is option C. The Defense Minister budget has been increases to over rupees 3 lakh crore. Additional fund for defense will be provided if needed. Let's see some highlights of the interim budget 2019. Income tax exemption limit raised up to rupees 5 lakhs annual income to get full tax rebate. Current fiscal accounts to be contained to 2.5%. Fiscal deficit has been brought down to 3.4% in the financial year 2019. Rs. 60,000 crore allocated for aging NREGA under PM Gram Sadak Yojana for a year. Rs. 19,000 crore allocated for rural roads under Gram Sadak Yojana. PM Kisan Samman Nidhi announced at Rs. 75,000 crore. No tax on bank interest up to Rs. 40,000. To know more about the highlights, follow us in our website. Let's move on to our next question, question number 2. According to National Sample Survey Office survey result, what is the percentage of unemployment in India in the year 2017-2018? The correct answer is option C, 6.1%. So let us know more about this survey result. As per National Sample Survey Office Periodic Labour Force Survey, India's unemployment rate hit 6.1% in 2017-18. It is the first comprehensive survey on employment conducted by a government agency for demonetization. Unemployment is higher in urban areas, which is 7.8% as compared to 5.3% in rural areas of the country. The unemployment rate is at its highest level as in 1972-73. Unemployment rate among youth reached a record high level in 2017-18 as compared to that in the overall population. Youths moving away from the agriculture sector as it is become less remunerative and moving to urban areas. Rate of jobless rural males rose to 17.4% from 5%, and among rural jobless females the rate become 13.6% from 4.8%. Let us learn more about the National Sample Survey Office. It is responsible to conduct large-scale sample survey in the diverse field on all India basis. Data are collected through national-wide household surveys on various socio-economic subjects, annual survey of industries. The NSSO is functioning under the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation. The minister responsible for NSSO is D.V. Sandananda Gowda. Heading to our next question, question number 3. Which state government approved for Smart Village campaign worth rupees 385 crore? The correct answer is option A, Punjab. Let us know more about this scheme. The Punjab government approved a rural development scheme Smart Village campaign worth ₹384.40 crore. The campaign aims to improve the conditions of rural areas by supplementing the ongoing government schemes for building infrastructure and providing essential amenities. It was approved by the Chief Minister Amarinder Singh. Reformation and implementation of the scheme would be financed with the funds from the 14th Financial Commission and Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. Let us learn about the Punjab state. The capital of Punjab is Chandigarh. The Chief Minister is Amarinder Singh. The Governor is V.P. Singh Badnor. The Punjab has a total of 13,276 villages. Now, let's move on to our next question, question number 4. Who was re-elected as a new Bharat India chairman? The correct answer is option A, Puneet Goenka. So let us learn more about this re-election. Puneet Goenka, Managing Director and CEO of Zee Entertainment Enterprises Limited, has been re-elected the new chairman of TV Viewership Measurement Company, Bark India. Puneet Goenka was the founder of Bark India. He succeeded Nakul Chopra, who completed his year-long tenure as chairman. Now, let's see about Bark India, that is Broadcast Audience Research Council India. Bark was founded in 2010. The chairman of Bark India is Nakul Chopra. The CEO is Partho Dasgupta. Bark is an industry body set up to design, commission, supervise, and own an accurate, reliable, and timely television audience measurement system for India. Heading to our next question, question number 5. RBI lifted its curb on Dash under Prompt Corrective Action Framework. RBI lifted its curb on three banks as it breached PCA framework parameters of crossing 6% net. The correct answer is option A, Bank of India, Bank of Maharashtra, and Oriental Bank of Commerce. Recently, the RBI has decided to allow three public sector banks, Bank of India, Bank of Maharashtra, and Oriental Bank of Commerce, to exit the PCA framework following capital infusion by the government and a decline in net non-performing asset ratio. Let's see about PCA framework. RBI introduced a new framework called Prompt Corrective Action to regulate banks' non-performing asset. It was started in 2002. IDBI Bank was the first bank to come under PCA framework. Capital, asset quality, and profitability parameters would form the basis on which PCA will analyze a bank's performance. The trigger points for RBI to monitor, assess, and take corrective measures on banks are capital to risk-weighted ratio, net non-performing asset, return on assets, and leverage ratio. Let's move on to our next question, question number 6. As per the Ministry of Finance, the total GST revenue collected in the month of January is dash. The correct answer is option C, 1 lakh crore. The government said that the goods and service tax collections crossed the rupees 1 lakh crore mark in January. Let's know more about GST. The Goods and Service Tax is an indirect tax or consumption tax levied in India on the supply of goods and service. It came into effect from July 1, 2017. GST is divided into 5 tax slabs for collection of tax: 0%, 5%, 12%, 18%, and 28%. Moving on to our next question, question number 7. Who was appointed as the Director General of National Cadet Corps? The right answer is option A, General Rajiv Chopra. Lt. Gen. Rajiv Chopra took charge as the Director General of National Cadet Corps in New Delhi. He has been awarded Ati Vishisht Seva Medal for his distinguished service in January 2018. He took part in an infantry battalion in Operation Rhino and a brigade in Eastern Command. He was the Inspector General of Insurgency Torn State of Manipur. Heading to our 8th question. Using Artificial Pancreas smartphone app, one can analyze dash. There are some questions that contain its answers. This is one such question. The word pancreas can be related to insulin, which in turn connects it to diabetes. Yes, the answer for the question is option A, diabetics. Scientists developed an artificial pancreas smartphone app that will help to analyze blood sugar levels in diabetes patients. This application is formed with the capacity to connect with glucose monitors, insulin pump devices, and decision-making algorithms. This app is capable of interfacing wirelessly with glucose monitors, insulin pump devices, and decision-making algorithms. A clinical trial showed that the artificial pancreas system app is safe. The app is effective in regulating glucose levels under challenging conditions and is suitable for use in unconstrained environments. The app system showed an improvement time in the target glucose range, that is 70 to 180 micrograms per deciliter, and yielded a statistically significant reduction in time below 70 micrograms per deciliter. Moving on to our next question, question number 9. Who is appointed as the interim CEO of Yes Bank? The answer for the question is option A, Ajay Kumar. Ajay Kumar is appointed as the interim CEO of Yes Bank. He will hold the charge of Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer till the new CEO Ravneet Gill joins the lender. Yes Bank said that the Reserve Bank of India had approved the interim appointment. Now let's learn about Yes Bank. The Yes Bank was founded in 2004. The type of Yes Bank is banking and financial services. The founder is Rana Kapoor, Ashok Kapoor. It is headquartered at Mumbai, Maharashtra. The non-executive chairman is Brahm Dutt. The MD and CEO of Yes Bank is Rana Kapoor. Yes Bank is India's fourth largest private sector bank. Here we are heading to our last question, question number 10. How much did the government announce for the PM Kisan scheme in the interim budget 2019? The answer for the question is option B, ₹75,000 crore. Government has announced that it is to allocate ₹75,000 crore per year to support farmers' incomes. It is after the impact of ₹20,000 crore in current fiscal year. The vulnerable farmers will receive ₹6,000 per year in 3 equal installments. Government will also allocate ₹60,000 crore for UPA's flagship MNREGA in 2019-20. Let us learn about Pradhan Mantri Kisan Sampada Yojana. It was introduced on May 2017. Its aim is to supplement agriculture, modernize processing and decrease agri-waste, implementation of mega food parks, integrated cold chain and value addition infrastructure, food safety and quality assurance infrastructure, etc. are ongoing. And new schemes like infrastructure for agro-processing clusters, creation of backward and forward linkages, creation or expansion of food processing and preservation capacities are upcoming under the scheme. To conclude this session, here comes the question of the day. RBI introduced a new framework called Prompt Corrective Action to Regulate Banks. Try to answer the question and drop your answers in the comment box. Okay friends, that's for today. Thanks for watching our video. If you find the information provided in our video useful, please do like, share and subscribe our YouTube channel. Follow us regularly to stay updated on current affairs. Until then, this is Freshers Live signing out from Current Affairs Video. Take care.